Live from Studio 67, it's time to and now your host, Kyle Ma.
Hey everybody, welcome to Do Something Interesting, where we have people do great things here. We have a great guest for you today. His name is Juan Rodriguez. He's a part of the crew here, but he decided to not be behind the camera anymore. He wants to be on camera. So after a lump sum of $1,200, we gave him permission to come up here and do it. That's coming right after this break, so stick around. Thanks for sticking around here on Do Something Interesting. We have a great talent for you. His name is Juan Rodriguez. Let's give a round of applause. Come on in, Juan. Take it away.
All right, this is Happier Than Ever. When I'm away from you, I'm happier than ever. Wish I could explain it better. I wish it wasn't true. Give me a day or two to think of something clever, to write myself a letter to tell me what to do. Do you read my interviews, or do you skip my avenue when you said you were passing through? Was I even on your way? I knew when I asked you to be cool about what I was telling you. You do the opposite of what you said you do, and I'd end up more afraid. Don't say it isn't fair. You clearly weren't aware that you made me miserable. So if you really wanna know, when I'm away from you, I'm happier than ever. Wish I could explain it better. I wish it wasn't true. You call me again, drunk in your Benz, driving home under the influence. You scare me to death, but I'm wasting my breath, 'cause you only listen to your effing friends, and I don't relate to you. I don't relate to you, no, Cause I never treat me this itty. You made me hate this city. And I don't talk ish about you on the internet. Never told anyone anything bad. Cause that is embarrassing. You were my everything. And all that you did was make me effing sad. So don't waste the time I don't have. And don't try to make me feel bad. I could talk about every time that you showed up on time. But I'd have an empty line, cause you never did. Never paid any mind to my mother or friends. So I shut them all out for you, cause I was a kid. You ruined everything good. Always said you were misunderstood. Made all your moments my own. Just effing leave me alone. Yeah.
Whether you learn best in an online environment or you prefer a face-to-face experience, Nash Community College offers both to meet your educational goals. If you're looking to enhance your skills or need a new calling, NCC provides short-term training opportunities that lead to new careers. You can schedule a campus tour or request information directly at nashcc.edu/info. Enroll today and get your future started.
Welcome back. Hope you guys enjoyed that amazing talent. Juan, thanks for coming out today, man.
Oh, thank you for having me.
What gave you the confidence to come out here and show your talent like this?
Honestly, I've been doing this for a while, so it was kind of easy for me.
How long have you been singing, really?
I want to say since I was like 4 or 5 years old.
4 or 5 years old. Yes. I don't even know if I could talk then. I'm going to be honest with you.
I don't even know if I could.
Took me until I was 13. Really? Fun fact. So why'd you pick this song? There's obviously a reason.
Yes.
You had one day's notice. You picked this as your song. How come? Give me the whole story.
The whole shebang. The whole story.
The whole shebang. I want it all. I want the meat.
Okay, cool. Well, I mean, first of all, I love this song. You know, and it's like a very emotional song. But the reason that I chose the song is because, we all have somebody or someone or a group of people that we've encountered throughout our lives that we just wish we had really hadn't met or been around them because they really didn't do anything good for us.
Yeah.
It could be like a toxic family as well. And so the way I took the song, I interpreted it differently because originally it was written as a heartbreak song. Mm-hmm. But I took my own interpretation of it, and that's the beauty of music. Like, an artist can write a song, but you take that song and you attach it to some type of memory, some type of feeling.
Yeah.
So that's the reason I did it.
Well, it was very, very good.
Thank you.
Who sings this song?
Billie Eilish.
And it's called
Happier Than Ever. Yes.
Have you always been a fan of her, even when she first came out?
I wish I had been since the start of it.
Yeah, like 2015, I believe.
Yeah.
I had here on my handy note card.
I wish I had, like, you know, like, honestly, if I had listened to her music around that time.
Yeah.
I don't know, man. I'd be doing amazing.
I don't listen to her enough because I'm going to be honest. She makes me cry like a small child.
Oh, my God.
And
you need a box of tissues for her music.
I can't have that around here. I got to be, you know, I got to be the host.
Yeah, but I want to say that it started up like back in 2017.
That's 2017. Yeah. So that was that. Yeah, I know exactly when that was. Because she's one of the biggest superstars probably in the world now.
Absolutely.
And maybe one day you'll be one of the biggest superstars in the world.
Let's hope.
And you can plug, do something interesting.
Absolutely.
Please, we need it.
Yes.
Plug us.
I'll try my best.
So you said you started singing around 4 years old. Did you always know that you were pretty good, or were you just kind of doing it for fun? Or did you really know that, like, oh, I may be pretty good at this?
Honestly, I'm not trying to toot my own horn or anything.
We love the tooting. We're pro toot here on this show.
Yeah.
In toot that away. Case,
okay. No, I kind of knew since I was young, you know, that I mm-hmm. wanted to do music, and I kind of knew that I did an okay job. You know, I did okay. Like, I did mm-hmm. good. I don't want to say, like, I did awesome. But
we think you did pretty awesome.
Yeah, so I kind of knew. I mean, I would sing, like, with, like, in family gatherings, you know, like, for example, the holidays. They would be like, hey, can you sing that song? You sing it really well. Like, yeah. you should sing for us.
And I'm like, another wide. You ever sing that song?
Christmas? I have heard it, yes.
You should sing it at the next Christmas party.
Maybe I should.
Over some pudding and some fruitcake.
Oh, yeah, that sounds good.
So, have you ever wanted to, like, audition for, like, one of the big shows, like American Idol or The Voice? And if so, which one would you prefer?
Okay, so I have auditioned for American Idol.
Get out of town.
For real.
Like, I swear I didn't know that. That's
crazy. Yeah, I auditioned back in 2018.
You just blew my mind.
Oh, well, it's just like...
So, did you meet the people, like, who the judges were?
Well, actually, there's, like, a process.
Okay. Tell me about the process, because I don't understand it.
Yeah, there's, like, three auditions.
Three auditions, okay.
Yeah.
I thought there was one.
So the first audition is with, like, members of, like, the crew or whatever, you know, like, production crew or just judges, as they call them, you know, people who are there kind of, like, looking for talent. And then if you get past them, you have another audition. And then if you get past that audition, then you get to be in front of the judges.
So you're telling me that dude who sang that song, Pants on the Ground, from one of those seasons made it through two auditions?
I'm guessing so. I mean, so, look, they do all types of things. Like, they got a lot of people. It's a reality TV show. I mean,
oh, yeah,
so
of course.
They got to have a little bit of everything. So they got, I don't know how people who can't sing make it. Obviously, it's just for show, really. So.
Yeah, I feel like they let some people slip through the cracks just to kind of entertain people.
Yeah, I mean, it gives
like
a good
the
laugh.
The really awful people who get up there, like, we've seen some bad people.
Yeah.
Where it's like, you want to mute your TV.
For real.
I can't even deal with this. So you auditioned for American Idol. That's crazy.
I did. Sadly, I didn't make it. I think only about 8 people made it out of Charlotte.
That's crazy.
Yeah, it's crazy because I saw a lot of people like who were really talented in the line, like, you know, people who could actually play an instrument.
Yeah.
And people who like had amazing vocals, but they were all sent home, really.
That's crazy. How many shows are there now? There's the American Idol, which got canceled, but it's now back.
Yeah.
There's The Voice, and their hosts change every episode, I feel. Because it used to be Maroon 5 guy.
Yeah.
But now he's
I think
gone.
They got, I'm not sure, I think it's Ariana Grande now and some other hosts. Yeah.
Huh.
But back to your question, though, honestly, I don't even know if I would audition anymore. I kind of already got the experience of it, how it works.
You got the process down.
Yeah, but if I was to audition to any type of a, you know, like talent show or anything like that, I'd probably do The Voice, maybe.
The Voice is very entertaining.
Yeah, it really is, and I think I would probably
Or you
do
can
that.
Get really famous and do The Masked Singer.
Or that?
So first you got to get famous first,
in
maybe
time.
For like something
time
else.
Will tell.
Something else. Mm-hmm. So we were talking backstage about your trips out west. You said you've been to San Fran and places like that. Have you ever thought about moving out there?
Absolutely, I love
like
San
this?
Francisco. honestly, that's part of the reason that I kind of enrolled in like the program I'm in my school. You know.
Yeah.
And
which program is that?
Broadcasting.
Broadcast production. Yeah. Okay.
Cameras.
Yeah.
So. Yeah, I had a trip this year in June, and I was honestly going through a lot. It was like one of those moments where you kind of need a getaway trip, you know?
Sometimes you need to do that.
Yeah, and I was reflecting a lot, and I was there out there by the beach, and I was walking, and it was just awesome. And I had like a little, an epiphany of some sorts, you know?
Yeah.
And I was like, you know what? Like, I don't really like the job I'm in. I want to enroll in the broadcasting program, and I want to get back into singing because I had kind of stopped for a while.
Follow your dreams.
And yeah, and I've been doing it a lot lately. I've been working.
That's awesome.
But and so that's exactly what I did when I came back from San Francisco. I quit my job at Merck, and I enrolled in the Nash Community Program, and I started working on my voice.
Yeah. Well, we're all here. I know we're all very glad that you did. And we're very glad that you decided to do this show. So thank you for
thank
coming
you.
On. It was been a pleasure, and it was awesome. We're going to be right back. Let's give a round of applause for Juan. Did a great job. We'll be right back. We're going to a quick commercial break. I'll see you on the other side. Hey guys, hope you enjoyed today's episode of Do Something Interesting. We have great talents every other Friday, like this. Magic. It's kind of stuff we do here on Do Something Interesting. Keep it casual. All right, if you want to send in your talent to be on the show with whoever's the host, sadly won't be me anymore. But if you want to send in your talent, contact this email address right here. It's my very own personal email address. Come straight to the source. And not this Friday, but next Friday, Juan himself is going to come on and host. Don't know who the talent is yet. Could be you. So I'll see you then.